61's Emma Wolforst is live in the Fox 61 newsroom. She's been speaking with people who've been calling and talking with state officials, too. Viewers across the state, Emma, what are you hearing?
Well, Sarah, Keith, this was definitely a surprise for all of us this morning. I'm standing here at the assignment desk where this morning our phones were basically ringing off the hook with viewers calling from Bridgeport to Enfield wanting to tell us that they felt this earthquake.
I was like, what the heck was that? And it sounded like there was a freight train.
From New Jersey.
Suddenly everything starts rocking. Our glasses start shaking a little bit.
To New York.
It just felt like being on a boat for a second. Like it felt like it was really disorienting, almost surreal. Like the whole floor was kind of wobbling and the building was shaking back and forth.
To right here in Connecticut. People feeling the effects of a 4.8 magnitude earthquake around 10:30 Friday morning.
All of a sudden, my desk started shaking, and I've got two monitors, and they were doing a little jiggly-jiggly.
Then I started to notice my plants kind of wavering around. Like I have some like monsteras that are pretty tall, and they started like waving back and forth.
Viewers calling and emailing Fox 61 Friday morning in Burlington. Linda told us her house was shaking with pictures and decor moving, writing she, quote, actually heard a noise like a train locomotion sound in the room, calling the experience scary. Wanda in Bloomfield told us she'd never experienced an earthquake before and thought her home was falling apart.
It was really scary to have being up on the sixth floor and have the whole building shaking around you.
Local officials snapping into gear across the state, feeling the rumbles themselves.
I was sitting in my office on Country Club Road in Middletown in a meeting, and I felt it.
Emergency services says there haven't been any reports of injuries or significant damages, but they're still keeping a close eye on infrastructure.
Our crews were out really prioritizing the most critical infrastructure. You know, think Gold Star Bridge out in New London or the Route 8 I-84 Mixmaster in Waterbury, the really big, tall structures.
With thousands of bridges and aging infrastructure in Connecticut, the department wants to make sure everything is safe.
Any cracks, looking at the surface area, if those bridge joints aren't tight together, anything that would maybe show that there was some potential movement to the structure and that it's not settled in the position where it normally should be.
And as crews continue monitoring roads and bridges throughout the weekend and prepare for any aftershocks, those who felt the quake Friday say it was a pretty unexpected way to end their week.
It's New York City. Like, I expect a blizzard, maybe a good hurricane every once in a while. I don't expect tornadoes and I don't expect earthquakes. Those are the two things I've ruled out. And yet here we are, beginning of April, and bam, earthquake right there.
And state officials want people to keep an eye out for any possible damage, even if it's minor, like cracks in the road. If you see anything, report it to your town or city's Department of Emergency Services so they can go check it out. Sarah, Keith.